Hey guys, I just finished filming a tutorial on myself, actually. Not really tutorial, but like filmed a video of me putting on falsies for the first time, false eyelashes. And I wanted to keep it a more natural look, but I said it's just too much fun. I wanted to go ahead and add a little color to this. I'm going to show you how to do a peekaboo rainbow. I'm not going to put a lot of color on my eyelid, just a little bit, so that when like you close your eyes, like people see a little rainbow by your eye, on your lower eyelid. I already have like a more natural, really neutral color. My nose is always itching here. I have a neutral color here already, but I'm going to take a white shadow to give a little bit of a base and apply it on the lid here, just on the bottom. It's kind of not fair. Oh look, that's where the glue is. Okay, it's kind of not fair because I cheated. I already applied liner from the last video, so I won't really be applying liner after I do this. I might, in case I get fallout. So I drop more of white. You can use white, a matte white, or a frosty white. And now I'm taking the red liner and I'll do it on this eye so you can see better. I'm adding a little bit of red. See that? I'm not going over this crease here. I'm gonna keep it low. Let's do the other eye. I feel like I'm playing Twister. Having to switch back and forth. Later, I'm gonna clean it up a little bit, but I'm not gonna concentrate on that right now. I don't have an orange liner, so I'm going to go and take orange, go into an orange shadow that I do have, and bring that right next to the red. Because the colors of the rainbow are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, pink. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, pink. In school, they used to tell us it's Roy G. Biv, just so that we can remember it. Growing up, of course. Red, orange. I also don't have a yellow pencil, so I'm going to take a yellow shadow from the palette that my 2-year-old destroyed. It looks like nothing right now, but have some patience and wait to see when it's finished. Freaky. Definitely have some fallout. So, how are you today? Anything exciting happen in your life today? Or did you just wake up without having a cup of coffee yet? Like I did. Actually, I'm into decaf now because I was suffering terrible headaches and I was tired of taking medicine for it. So, I mean, when you have a headache, it means your body's telling you something's wrong. You don't just have pains in your body without there being something wrong. So, and you don't just take painkillers, it just covers it up. So I started watching what I was eating or drinking and seeing how I reacted to it, and I decided to switch to decaf coffee because I used to drink a lot of coffee, and I guess it did have something to do with my headaches, because since I switched to decaf, the headaches, it's been two weeks, and the headache didn't come back, thank God, because I cannot function when I have a headache. I can't do anything. When I used to have my migraines, I would just like stay in bed all day. I couldn't. If I smelled anything, if I even smelled food, I would want to throw up. And that is not fun. Especially when you have a house you need to take care of and things to do. So there's the green. And blue. Cute, no? Now you're starting to see the rainbow a little bit. And purple. I'm not gonna put any pink because I think purple is good enough. I'm actually gonna use the purple and wing it out somewhat. Just to give it a hint of color extending from the eye. Can you see that? I hope it doesn't look too clowny. Once I clean it up, it'll look better. I'm back. So I have my Q-tip here. And then I'm going to clean up anything that's extending past the crease. Just so that when I blink, you can see the color. You want just an interesting hint of color. You don't want to look. See? Wait a minute. You don't want to look all clowny like. Unless you're looking for that look if you're going to a circus or a carnival or something like that. With your little brothers or sisters or children if you have any. So you see that now, see what I have on? Now I'm going to just take a blending brush to slightly blend the colors in. But you're just gonna blend the top part. So it's more wearable. So it doesn't look like you have a line of red. A section of red, I mean, a section of yellow, a section of blue. You kind of want to softly blend that in. Oh, you like my earrings? Aren't they cute? They're like a herringbone pattern. I thought it was cute. I just got it at a, believe it or not, at a beauty supply store. The store is called Beauty Star. I don't think it's a chain or anything. I think it's like privately owned. But cute stuff. So how do you like that? I think it's cute. I think it's interesting. You know, if you're gonna go to a beach, even just don't get wet. If you just plan on tanning or something. And don't forget the sunscreen. And there you have it. Oh, you know what? I'm going, since I did get a little fallout, I'm going to go over the liner. So tell me, this is the first time I applied falsies. I'll attach a link to my falsie video. But do people reuse these things? Like, what do you do with these caterpillars once they fall off? And there you have it. What do you do with them? Are you allowed to reuse them? I don't know. No one ever spoke about that. So, hope you like the tutorial. I think it's cute, don't you? I mean, not to be vain or anything. I think it's just a cute look. It's like, right now you don't see I'm wearing a rainbow, but when I'm blinking, you see. Peekaboo. So there you have it. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. My phone's ringing. Hold. There you go. Sorry. So I'm going to end off this message. End off this tutorial with a positive message of the day. This is called You Can Turn Things Around by Alan Austin. You are a special person, one who is given a wonderful gift with each new dawn. You have so many moments ahead of you in life. A thousand blessings yet to come, a world of wonder still to experience, a closeness with all creation and people who care. You can do whatever you hope to do. It's never too late to reach for your dreams you want to pursue. There is never too little time to strive, too little strength to climb, or too few goals to achieve. You can turn things around. When I look at you, I envision a dream coming true and someone in whom I believe. Wasn't that nice? That's by Alan Austin. Never let anyone ever tell you can't do something, or never let like negative experiences get you down. The negative things that happen to life are just like for us to learn a lesson and to grow strong from it. And if you have any negative people in your life who always say, no, you can't do that, no, what are you doing that, no, that's too hard, no, what are you thinking, don't listen to them. Those are like negative energy sucking people. Usually when, like, if I meet someone like that, I just try to stay away from them. I mean, I know it's shady, but I don't, like, I try to avoid them. I'm trying to be nice. I don't want to tell them, look, you're a very negative person. I don't want to be with you anymore. I think if you do it, like, subtly, like, I guess they'll get the hint and, like, stop, like, calling you or whatever. But, yeah, I don't know. That's just me. I think I'm more sensitive about people's feelings. I'm not that I'm fake, but people have feelings and people might take things the wrong way. I might like a certain person for certain qualities, but I just can't be around negative people. It's just like, it gets you down. You want to be around more positive people. Positive people bring positive energy and it'll get you a boost. It'll give you kind of a boost when you want to like get things done, or people who have like good ideas and stuff like that. Anyway, I don't want to, I always make my videos too long. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Like it, don't like it, tell me what you think, and have a great day. Be positive, stay positive. Bye.